हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ एस एम माली, लेक्चरर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, गोगटे पीयू कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेळगावी. वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय 8th लेक्चर ऑन इंडेक्स नंबर्स. सिंस प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी आर सॉल्विंग 10 मार्क्स क्वेश्चंस ऑन इंडेक्स नंबर्स. इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद दैट, today we will solve some more 10 mark questions on index numbers. Today's first question is, compute Fisher's ideal price index number and also verify whether it satisfies time reversal test and factor reversal test. Here the data is given as base year price and quantities are given and current year price and quantities are given. First, in the solution we have to denote these price and quantities in base year and current year. So base year price is denoted by P0 and base year quantity is denoted by Q0, whereas current year price is denoted by P1 and current year quantity is denoted by Q1. Then we need to add some more columns, that is, first column is P0 into Q0 we have to find. That is, 5 into 25 you will get 125, then 10 into 5 is 50. 3 into 40 is 120 and last is 6 into 30 is 180. So if we add all P0 Q0 values, we will get summation P0 Q0 is equal to 475. Similarly, we need to find P0 into Q1, that is, 5 into 30 we will get 150, 10 into 4 we will get 40, 3 into 50 is 150 and last is 6 into 35 you will get 210. Then by adding all P0 Q1 values, we will get summation P0 Q1 is equal to 550. Then we will calculate P1 into Q0, that is, 6 into 25 you will get 150, 15 into 5 you will get 75, 4 into 40 is 160 and last is 8 into 30 is 240. Then by addition of all P1 Q0 values, you will get summation P1 Q0 is equal to 625. Similarly, we will calculate P1 into Q1, that is, 6 into 30 is 180, 15 into 4 is 60, 4 into 50 is 200 and the last is 8 into 35 is equal to 280. Then by adding all P1 Q1 values, you will get summation P1 Q1 is equal to 720. So we required all these totals to solve this example further. Now first we need to find Fisher's ideal price index number, and the formula is P01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1 into 100. So we will put all the totals which are available in the previous table, so which is equal to square root of 625 divided by 475 into 720 divided by 550 into 100. After simplification, you will get square root of 1.3158 into 1.3091 into 100, so which is equal to multiply the square root quantities, you will get square root of 1.7225 into 100. Then after square root, you will get 1.3124 into 100. Therefore, the Fisher's ideal price index number is 131.24. Now we have to show that Fisher's index number satisfies time reversal test and factor reversal test. For that, we require Fisher's price index, that is without proportionality constant, means without multiply by 100, we are going to write the formula. That is P01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation P1Q0 divided by summation P0Q0 into summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q1. Remember, here we are not multiplying by 100. So, which is equal to square root of 625 divided by 475 into 720 divided by 550. So, we will denote this as equation number 1. Like that, we require Fisher's price index with reversed time. Means we have to replace 1 by 0 and 0 by 1 in the previous equation number 1. That is, P10 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation P0Q1 divided by summation P1Q1 into summation P0Q0 divided by summation P1Q0. What we did here, just in the equation number 1, wherever 1 is there, we have replaced 1 by 0, and wherever 0 is there, that we replace by 1, and we have the formula. So, which is equal to square root of, according to these changed notations, we will put the values. So, we have square root of 550 divided by 720 into 475 divided by 625. We will denote this as equation number 2. Therefore, the condition for time reversal test, that is P01 into P10, is equal to 1. So, this is the condition to satisfy time reversal test. So, according to this above equation, we will put the values by using equation 1 and equation 2, that is square root of 625 divided by 475 into 720 divided by 550, this is equation number 1, into square root of 550 divided by 720 into 475 divided by 625, it is available in equation number 2, which is equal to 1. How you can observe here, in both the square root, the same values in the numerator and denominator get cancelled, and that I have shown here with the same color. That is 625 get cancelled with 625, then 475 get cancelled with 475, 720 get cancelled with 720, and 550 get cancelled with 550. So, remaining is 1. Therefore, we can say that Fisher's index number satisfies time reversal test. Also, we have to show that Fisher's index satisfies factor reversal test. For that, Fisher's quantity index number is required, and that is also without proportionality constant. So, Fisher's quantity index without proportionality constant is Q01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation Q1P0 divided by summation Q0P0 into summation Q1P1 divided by summation Q0P1. So, which is equal to square root of 550 divided by 475 into 720 divided by 625, and we will denote this as equation number 3. Now, the condition to satisfy factor reversal test is P01 into Q01, which is equal to summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q0. Now P01 is available in equation number 1 and Q01 is available in equation number 3. So we will put all these values. Then we have square root of 625 divided by 475 into 720 divided by 550 into another square root 550 divided by 475 into 720 divided by 625. Here also in both the square root the same values in the numerator and denominator get cancelled, that is 625 get cancelled with 625 and 550 get cancelled with 550. So remaining values we will write as it is. So in the first square root remaining is 720 divided by 475 into, in the second square root remaining is 720 divided by 475. So both the square root same values, so square root get cancelled and we will write ones, that is 720 divided by 475. Now 720 is nothing but summation P1 Q1 and 475 is nothing but summation P0 Q0, that is P01 into Q01 is equal to summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Therefore Fisher's index number satisfies factor reversal test. Now let's see another example. For the following data, compute Fisher's ideal price index number. Show that Fisher's index number satisfies time reversal test and factor reversal test for the given data. Here data is given, price in the year 2016 and 2018 are given. Also quantity in the year 2016 and 2018 is given. Here 2016 is a base year and 2018 is a current year. So in the solution, first we will denote all the values, that is price in the year 2016, that is base year, is denoted by P0, and price in the current year, that is 2018, is denoted by P1. Also quantity in the year 2016, that is base year, is denoted by Q0, and quantity in the current year, that is 2018, is denoted by Q1. Then we need to find P0 into Q0. So you will get 9 into 3 is 27, 20 into 9 is 180, and last is 10 into 5 is 50. If we add all these values, you will get summation P0 Q0 is equal to 257. Then we require P0 into Q1, that is 9 into 6, you will get 54. Then 20 into 10 is 200, and the last is 10 into 6 is 60. By adding all these values, you will get summation P0 Q1 equal to 314. Then we need to find P1 into Q0, that is 9 into 3 is 27, 21 into 9 is 189, and 15 into 5 is 75. Then you will get total of this is summation P1 Q0 is equal to 291. And at the last we need to find P1 into Q1, that is 9 into 6 is 54. Then 21 into 10 is 210, and 15 into 6 you will get 90. So by adding all P1 Q1 values, you will get summation P1 Q1 is equal to 354. Now we have to find Fisher's ideal price index number. So we have the formula P01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation P1 Q0 divided by summation P0 Q0 into summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q1 into 100. Now all the totals we will put in this formula. Then we have
P01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of 291 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 314 into 100, which is equal to square root of 291 divided by 257. You will get 1.1323 into 354 divided by 314. You will get 1.1274 into 100. Then multiply the square root quantity, that is 1.1323 into 1.1274. You will get square root of 1.2766 into 100. Take the square root, you will get 1.1298 into 100. Therefore, Fisher's ideal price index number is 112.98. Now we have to show that Fisher's index satisfies time reversal test and factor reversal test. For that, we required Fisher's price index number formula without proportionality constant. As I told in the previous example, without multiply by 100. So we have P01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation P1Q0 divided by summation P0Q0 into summation P1Q1 divided by summation P0Q1, which is equal to, put all these totals, you will get square root of 291 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 314. Therefore, P01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of 291 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 314. That is equation 1. Now, we required Fisher's price index number with reversed time. So, as I told, reversed time is Fisher's price index number formula. In that, we have to replace 1 by 0 and 0 by 1. You will get Fisher's price index with reversed time. That is, P10 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation P0Q1 divided by summation P1Q1 into summation P0Q0 divided by summation P1Q0, which is equal to square root of 314 divided by 354 into 257 divided by 291. These all totals you will get in the table. So we will denote this as equation number 2. Now the condition for time reversal test is P01 into P10 is equal to 1. Now P01 is available in equation number 1 and P10 is available in equation number 2. So by putting equation 1 and 2, you will get square root of 291 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 314 into another square root, 314 divided by 354 into 257 divided by 291. Now, as I told in the previous example, here also the same values in the numerator in the first square root and in the denominator in the second square root get cancelled. That is, that I shown with the same color values. That is, 291 get cancelled with 291, 257 in the first square root get cancelled with 257 in the second square root. Similarly, 354 get cancelled with 354 and 314 get cancelled with 314 in the second square root. So all the values get cancelled, so remaining is 1. Therefore, we can say that Fisher's index number satisfies time reversal test. Here we have to show that Fisher's index number satisfies factor reversal test, and for that we require Fisher's quantity index number, and that is also without proportionality constant, means without multiply by 100.
So Fisher's quantity index without proportionality constant is Q01 of Fisher's is equal to square root of summation Q1 P0 divided by summation Q0 P0 into summation Q1 P1 divided by summation Q0 P1. So which is equal to, put all the totals, you will get square root of 314 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 291. So we will denote this as equation number 3. Now the condition for satisfying factor reversal test is P01 into Q01 is equal to summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Now P01 is available in equation number 1 and Q01 is available in equation number 3. So by using equation 1 and equation 3, you will get square root of 291 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 314 into again another square root, 314 divided by 257 into 354 divided by 291, which is equal to, here the common values in the first square root numerator get cancelled with the second square root denominator. So 291 get cancelled with 291 and 314 get cancelled with 314. So remaining in the first square root is 354 divided by 257, and in another square root remaining is 354 divided by 257. So same value in two square root, so which is equal to 354 divided by 257. Now here 354 is nothing but summation P1 Q1 and 257 is summation P0 Q0. Therefore we can say that P01 into Q01 is equal to summation P1 Q1 divided by summation P0 Q0. Therefore Fisher's index number satisfies factor reversal test. So these are some 10 mark questions on index numbers. In the next class, we will solve the examples on consumer price index number. Thank you.